So namaste, in this video I'm going to tell you how to do static simulation in SOLIDWORKS. So first of all, I'm going to draw a sketch as per my requirement. So I'm just creating an I-beam. You can create I-beam as per your requirement. You can customize whatever you feel like it's good for you. Select this line at the center, enter the value of 10 mm and 100 mm, let's say 50 mm, escape, make it horizontal, sorry, press Ctrl plus Z, select these two lines by pressing Ctrl, make it 80, and the distance from here to here is cancel. From this point to this point distance is 40. As you can see, our sketch is turned into black. It means that our drawing is fully defined. Now go to fixtures, click on extrude. Now select mid plane and then extrude to 1200 mm. Make sure you select these things. Click OK. After that, go to SOLIDWORKS add-in. Make sure you click on SOLIDWORKS simulation. After that, click on simulation. Go to study advisory. Click new study. Make sure you click on static. So a question arises in your mind, where is static simulation is used? Static simulation is used when you know that you have a body or chassis or a beam on which a constant load is applied that is not varying with time, that is remain constant. Okay. At that time you use static load. If your load is varying with time, that at that time you use normally non-linear or linear dynamic. Okay, currently I am assuming that my load is constant and it just putting here at a constant force. So click OK. Before I start this, I need to make the area on which my whole load will act. Press Ctrl plus 8. I am drawing this sketch now. I am assuming that my whole load is acting on this sketch. Now here what you will see when I go to simulation, so static, and I will show you something. Okay, first exit the sketch. Now click on part, click on apply favorable material, click paint carbon stream. After that go to fixture advisory, click on fixed geometry, select this face and this face, click OK. Now here comes the important thing, click on force. When I try to click on force, as you can see, I am selecting the whole beam, but I just want to select this particular sketch. So how can I do that? To do that, what I need to do is projection. So what you need to do is go to features, select curves, click on project curve, select this sketch. After that, in here select the face, click OK. Now you can see, oh sorry, I guess I'm doing something wrong. Right click on it, delete. Yes, I need to select split line, sorry for my mistake. So select split line, and after that select this face, click OK. As you can see, now I'm selecting this line only, I'm not selecting this whole beam. Go to SOLIDWORKS simulation, sorry, static. Now click on external loads, click on force, select this face. As you can see, I am selecting this face only. Before that I am selecting this whole beam, but I don't want, I just want my load will just act on here. So enter the value of 70,000 newton, or you can change the value as per your requirement, and make sure the arrow is acting downward direction, because my load is acting in y direction downwards, not in upward direction. If somebody say, hey, my load is acting upward direction, just click on reverse as you can see, the load is acting upward, but in my scenario the load is acting downward. After that, click OK. Now go to mesh, right click on mesh, click on create mesh, click OK. Here you will see this is how the mesh look like. Now right click on mesh, create mesh. Finer the mesh, the better the quality of the result. You can adjust the parameters like what should be the width, height, depth of your mesh parameters or nodes as per your requirement. In my case, I just prefer this normally will do for me. Remember, the my main aim is here just to tell you how to do a simulation. Okay, so you can adjust and create whatever you want. And remember one thing, higher the mesh rate, higher will be the quality of your result, but it will also increase your simulation time, etc. So I'm not going to do that. I'm just simply going to show you how to do that and how to plot graphs and other things in SOLIDWORKS static simulation. Now click on run this study. When you run this study, what will basically happening, that is calculate. Now here you see the graph. Now go to displacement, right click on it, click on show. Now the first thing you see is that the beam is bending too much, it's too much, but here you will see that the deflection is currently 4.025 × 10⁻¹, but this is not the 4.025 × 10⁻¹ because it is way more higher. So why is showing me like this? The reason is that SOLIDWORKS showing is so much deflection is because so that you know where it is deflecting. If it doesn't show like this, you will never know where it's deflecting. For example, from a naked point eye of view, you will never able to detect what is point. You never able to detect 0.1 mm deflection in a 1200 mm beam. So, how to see real deflection? So to do that, right click on it, click on edit definition, select true scale, click OK. As you can see, this is the true scale, this is the true deflection, but from your eye point of view, it look like a straight beam. So right click on it, click on edit definition, click automatic, click OK. Now right click on it, click on animate. Here you can see it is currently showing me 5 frames per second. You can change the frame per second by just adding the number of frames you want. And it's telling me the number of frames showing, for example 150, but for example, right click on it, animate, sorry, stop, enter the value of 60, click play. Now here you see it creating the frames, 60 fps, and you can get a deep detail how does it bending and where is the maximum displacement. And now you see it's a look very cool animation. From here on you get total clear picture how is going on. Now click on stop. After that, go to click on stress simulation, click on show. Now right click on it, click on section clipping. So here you can see I select a section and you can see where the load acts. You can select the section of the plane as per your requirement. Either you click on the arrow or choose the section where you want to see basically the stress in the beam at a particular point of length or width. It's quite handy and you can take the photos from here and you can use it in your simulation analysis or showing in your tables. 50 mm. Now let's see another thing we can do, ISO clipping. Here you can see where it's showing me the values above this value four lakh something. So if you want to show the stress at a particular value, for example you want to know where is the stress above this value is acting on it, so you can get a clear picture from here by ISO clipping. It shows where the stress above this value is acting on it. can also clone proton isosurfaces. So to get a clear picture, now let me show you another thing. Now right click on it, click on probe, select this line. Okay, I'm selecting this edge. Click on graph. On select, make sure you click on select identities. Sorry for mistake. Now select this line. Click update. Now click on graph. As you can see, it shows me a clear picture. How does my stresses is acting on this line? Remember, this line is just this this long, not the whole beam. You can select the whole beam as per your requirement, but I'm just showing this stress. Here, a question arises in your mind. The stress is basically plot in one missing stress and parametric distance. Parametric distance is nothing but that I told you previously, the mesh length, width. Remember, this is what the graph plots. The number of triangles here, it plots basically on that. That is what is statically nodal stress. Or you can save this file and use it in your, you know, Excel or sheet or somewhere as per your requirement. You just click on save, you will get that one. Now last thing is strain. Strain is basically, as we know, change in length upon original length. That is what we call strain. So you can animate it. Remember, all the parameters here showing are basically 200 times or 500 times than the original. So if you want to change it, I already show you how to change it as per your requirement. And here the frames are 60 FPS. So FPS means frame per seconds. So it gives you a clear picture how this animation goes on. Click on stop. Now click exit. Now click on plot tools, and you can save as this or animate it. Plot tools. Click save as. You can save the analysis in eDrawing files as per your requirement if you want. Okay, and section clipping is the same thing as I told you. If you want to see where is the strength at any point, length, width, or anywhere else, that is this you can easily see from here. Here you see the triangles here. So basically these are the nodes that I told you, that basically the mesh size. So because of the mesh size, these triangles are showing on. If you want to reduce them size, just reduce the size of your mesh and you will get a much better result from here on. And if anybody want to learn how to do nonlinear simulation, so here is a video. You can see how I'm doing a nonlinear simulation. You can get many things as a result. The link of this video is in the description. You can watch it. I hope this video is useful for you. If you have any doubts and queries, make sure you ask the comments. Thanks for watching and have a great day. Namaste.